musician. Hey, what's up guys, RST here, back again with another tech video for you guys. And today we're going to be unboxing something. No, I do not have my Lou unbox therapy set up yet. As you, that's my hat, this is my monitor, that's my laptop, okay, that's my mic. We do not have the Lou unbox therapy set up yet, but we're getting there. Just trust me on that, okay? But anyway guys, today we're going to be unboxing the Sony RX100 Mark V. Now, I've been shooting all my YouTube videos, or at least my in real life ones are, the ones I shoot, you know, actually of me and, you know, me unboxing something, on my iPhone. I've been shooting it on my iPhone 6S Plus, and now I'm starting to shoot it on my iPhone 7 Plus, which, you know, both videos are absolutely crispy. I get 1080p 60 on both phones, and that has been absolutely awesome, because I thought I never really needed to buy, you know, a proper camera for my videos. But now, we got this beast, and the reason it really drew me in is just because, look at the size of this. I mean, this is basically, you know, the size of my iPhone, and maybe even a little smaller. Just a quick size comparison here. These are two of my Tsum Tsums I got from Downtown Disney, and this is the RX100 Mark V. So in terms of height, it's about 1.5 Tsum Tsums. Yeah, 1.5 Tsum Tsums exactly. In terms of, if you're going by this way, it's about like a 2.25 Tsum Tsums. And but overall, it's a pretty good camera. I think width-wise. Hold on, let me turn. Oh my God! See guys, this is what happens when you measure with Tsum Tsums. Width-wise, we're looking at about in height in the back, I guess. You know. Just one and an eighth Tsum Tsum. So those are some measurements for you guys as a good size comparison. Just thought I, you know, let you know how big this camera is in terms of size and everything. And it shoots 4K video. Now the reason I don't use the iPhone's 4K video is because it always gets compressed somehow. Apple always compresses it somehow, because whenever I export it into my editing software, it always shows up as 720p. And that's what I always hate. I don't like, you know, I shoot a video in really high quality and I only get very low quality. I hate that. So hopefully this, I'm gonna get some really awesome 4K video. We got that tri-luminous color in here. We got HDMI support, which I love. And we got Dolby audio, which I don't use a mic. I don't usually use camera mics. I mean, the iPhone camera mic is absolute crap. I only use my Yeti. But yeah, that's cool that they got the, you know, Dolby Digital in there, and they got full 1080 HD. I wonder how many frames per second this shoots at, but it does have a really, really nice 20.1 megapixel sensor. So even if this doesn't turn out well for shooting videos, it's gonna be a great point and shoot camera. So let's unbox it right now. It's very easy to open, surprisingly. And no, I'm not dropping this like I did with my iPhone 7 Plus. But yeah, oh wow, they show you the warranty first thing. And all right, so we got some limited warranty. No one cares about that. No one cares about this. Using the viewfinder. What the hell is this? Capture One Express for Sony World. What the hell is this? Congratulations on your new Sony. Oh yeah, this is boring too. This is boring too. This is boring too. You know, I'm just gonna fast forward through all this boring stuff, okay? I'm just gonna wait till we get the camera. Okay? Okay guys, now we are finally at the camera. We got some nice fancy wrapping in here. I'm pretty sure this is the, please don't tell me they, why do they have cord in here? I freaking hate, oh my God, why do they put this plastic cord in here? I freaking hate plastic cord, because it's so hard to tear off. But okay, let's try and open this up. Let's put the box aside. My Mac's just dying right now, like over there. We got a nice little tag. I hate this plastic tag. Ooh, you don't want to scratch the lens. Oh, yeah, stick it out. Okay. Size comparison right off the bat. Not too heavy. It looks very nice. That I think this is the viewfinder. This is, or I'm not sure. This is the lens, obviously, for zooming it. We got a Carl Zeiss lens, obviously. That's absolutely fantastic. I really like this, you know, pop-up display. That's just really nice to me. I really like that because it lets you, you know, view things at an angle and stuff. That's really nice. Obviously, you got your, you know, your little dial right there. You got your trash can. You got your play button. You got your menu button. You got your movie button. That's the most important for me. You got your little, hold on, let me put it, the camera grip there. I like that little grip. Oh wow, that's a nice grip. Like, it's even a little soft too. I don't know if you guys can see it. That's very soft too. And we got our little mode switcher there. I like this grip. They put a little grip around the lens too. Oh man, this feels this is a really well made camera. Like, you can even feel this is like cold aluminum. Oh, they even got the 4K. They even got the 4K written on. Look at that. Exmer RS 4K Cybershot. Yeah, man, this camera looks absolutely awesome right now. So guys, if you're wondering how to access your viewfinder in your flash, it's pretty easy. So if you want to access the viewfinder, you click this finder button and then you go down and then, you know, it turns on by itself, obviously. That's the one thing that I like. And as you can see, it switches between a viewfinder and, you know, the regular, you know, standard screen. So if I'm looking through the viewfinder, it'll switch the screen over there. If I'm looking through the standard screen, it's gonna switch over there. That's awesome. And so I'm just gonna pop that down right there, and then the camera's gonna turn off. Now if you guys want your flash, you know, your manual flash, you just go over to the switch, pop it up, and you got your, you know, you got your nice little flash right there. And then you can just close it down like that. Okay, so let's turn it on, because that's obviously how I'm gonna use it. Is it charged at all? Is it? Come on. No charge? No charge? No charge? No. Well, folks, this is what happens when you don't unbox the rest of the box. The battery was actually in there the whole time. The reason it wasn't turning on was because I didn't even put in the battery. But just so you guys know, this is your charger, charging block, you know, standard charging block. Technically, you can use this for anything because it's a USB charging block. And then this is your charging cable. Again, you can probably use this for your Android phone because it's a, well, come on, why? What is with dropping things on the show? I freaking, but yeah, you can use this charger to charge your Android phone if you have one, or anything that uses a micro USB, because again, this is a pretty universal port when it comes to cameras and anything that doesn't have a lightning port or is designed by Apple. Okay, so let's move on to this camera. So now it's telling me to set up, trying to like get a good grip on it. Okay, so English, obviously. Is this touchscreen? Oh, come on, it's not touchscreen. Okay, so it's saying select and enter. Okay, so I'm gonna hit English. Select area, date, and time. This setup process looks to be taken, it looks like it's gonna take some time. So I'm gonna speed through the setup real quick. And yeah, I'll get back to you guys in a few.
2,000 years later.
All right, guys, I'm back, and I just turned the camera on. As you can see, the lens just went out full. As you can see that full Zeiss lens, and I can just tune this. Hold on. Yeah, I'm trying to get a good grip. This is like a terrible grip, but as you can see, as I slide the dial, you know, it's helping me pick my aperture and stuff, and my ISO, and you know, how I want to zoom my lens and stuff. But that is super neat that it has that little, you know, touchscreen UI on it, or touchscreen animation on it. I really like that. And it does shoot at 60 frames per second, which is pretty dang cool. Either that or it's 50, but I'm pretty sure it's 60 because of just of how smooth it is. It's really matching up with my iPhone. And as you can see, man, this is shooting it really well. As you, that's all the boring papers and stuff, but wow, the quality on it, just looking through the viewfinder, is just looking absolutely excellent right now. That's my hat. Those are my Disney toys. I like Disney a lot. That's Spoderman right there. Say hi to Spoderman. That's my Mac. But yeah, this camera already so far is looking pretty good. For first impressions, I'm obviously gonna do an in-depth review on this camera. Once I get some good time with it, I hope to, you know, shoot all my future videos should be shot on this camera. So hopefully you guys see somewhat of a difference in quality. I do want to film in 4K. I am going to start filming in 4K sooner or later. But yeah, stay tuned for that. And overall, but just first impressions on this camera, I'm really, really liking it. I'm really, really liking the Sony RX100 Mark V. Anyway, guys, that was the video for you guys today. Overall, my first impressions on this RX100 Mark V camera, it's looking pretty dope. I was just surprised overall, just looking through the, you know, the standard screen viewfinder, it's looking amazing right now. Now, I hope to get my video quality up to now 4K at 60 FPS instead of using this terrible compressed 4K, which isn't even 4K, it's actually 720p. And I hope to now use that for my videos and, you know, bump the quality of my videos to now 4K. And that's always great for you guys because now you guys can get way better quality videos from me. So yeah, I'm really looking forward to the content that is coming out from in the future from me. So stay tuned for that. And yeah, this is RST with another tech video for you guys. Peace.